All right, coming up in this segment, the Steve Lavelli Broadcast World Cup Uniform Colors Update Report thing. That's just in a few minutes from now, Eastern Time. But right now, it's the Audio Clip Trivia Quiz. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Mel Simons.
Okay, Steve. Well, thank you. Thank you, folks. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's nice, the way people applaud.
Isn't that lovely? A nice studio
thank
audience
you, folks.
We have
lovely
here,
audience. Thank you all. Here's our first toughie, Steve. This is for WBZ Penn.
All right.
But I think it's an easy toughie because the man has such a, I think, a distinctive voice. Here's a gentleman you all know, folks, very well-known, very famous gentleman, but you don't know him as a singer. A little bit out of context. A WBZ Penn is yours, gang. Identify the singer, please.
There's a day I danced to meet a soldier friend of mine. He'd been in camp for several weeks and he was looking fine. His muscles had developed and his cheeks were rosy red. I asked him how he liked the life and this is what he said. Oh, how I hate to get up in the morning. Oh, how I'd love to remain in bed. For the hardest blow of all is to hear the bugle call. Gotta get up, you gotta get up, you gotta get up this morning. Someday I'm going to murder the bugler. Someday you're going to find him dead. I'll amputate his reveille and set upon his reveille and spend the rest of my life in bed.
Well, I know I get you stumped because you get that kind of dingbat expression you have when you don't know who it is. But here's the interesting thing, Steve. After somebody guesses it,
yes.
Let's have Rob back it up, and you're going to say, oh, yeah, that's him, because I think his singing voice and his speaking voice are identical.
Mm.
Sometimes when you sing, it's not doesn't always sound the way
right.
you know when you
right.
talk. In this case, that is he.
Yeah.
So this is for
I
BZ
have
Penn.
A feeling about it, but I mean, like the voice is familiar.
Yeah.
But I cannot place it.
Okay.
Known as a singer.
Not known as a singer, but
so in other words, you're saying it's not Frank Sinatra.
That's a good guess, Steve. That's a terrific guess, but not quite.
Not Tony from Canton.
Not Tony
because
from Canton.
He is known as a singer.
Tony's a very fine singer.
Yes,
I've heard
he
him sing.
Me
yes,
too.
Indeed. No, not
I'm sure
Tony.
It's not him. Not, it didn't sound like him. He's much better than that.
Yeah. Oh, Tony's a singer. This guy is not known as a singer.
All right, not known as a singer. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. 617-254-1030 is the number. We go to the car. Bill, you're on WBZ.
Wild guess.
That'll do it, Bill. A wild guess.
Ray Bolger.
Guess what?
What?
No, that's not he. Now, Ray Bolger was known as a singer.
Yeah,
he was a
song and dance man,
yeah. A very successful one.
You have to be a singer to be a song and dance man.
That's well said, Steve. Yes,
thank you
agree.
Very much.
I don't always agree with you, but I agree with you on that one.
Thank you very much. We go to Boston. Joe, you're on WBZ.
Hi, Mel. Hi, Steve.
Hello there.
Joe.
I had all the other ones nailed. We're going to go.
Oh,
over.
Yeah, sure.
I'm sure that's the first time you heard that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've said it myself. That's how I know.
Right. I'm going to go on a limb, say Red Buttons.
No. Well, Red Buttons did sing, you know, primarily known as a comic, but he did sing a little bit. Interesting guess, but not he.
Okay, I tried.
Thanks for
sure
trying,
did.
Joe.
Thank you.
Let's go to North Carolina. Bob, you're on WBZ.
You know, I think they still think they're going to win it on Thursday because my birthday's Friday, but I thought they were going to win it tonight, too. So,
your lips to God's ears.
I'm going to go and take a wild stab and say Phil Silvers.
No, it's an interesting guess. Phil Silvers was not known as a singer. Incidentally, he was a clarinetist. Did you know that, Steve?
I did know that.
Played real, played real
I'd forgotten it, but now that you mention it,
played
yes.
Played a real good clarinet.
I actually remember seeing him play clarinet on television, maybe on somebody's variety
yeah,
show.
Yeah, he did
something.
That occasionally,
yeah.
Either with Mike or Murph or me, yeah. Even Ed Sullivan, but I do recall him playing clarinet on TV. He was good, too.
Thanks for trying, Bob.
All right, have a good night.
Take care.
Thank you.
We'll go to New Hampshire. Bill, you're on WBZ.
Walter Matthau.
How'd you come up with that?
You guys remind me of the Odd Couple, and I just put the link them together, and there it was.
Well, you're absolutely right. It is Walter Matthau. Way to go. Now, knowing that, Steve, can we have Rob back it up?
Yeah.
You're gonna say, oh, yeah,
let's
it's
hear
him.
That one more time and
sure.
See if that sounds like Walter Matthau to you, boys and girls.
There's a day I danced to meet a soldier friend of mine. He'd been in camp for several weeks and he was looking fine. His muscles had developed and his cheeks were rosy red. I asked him how he liked the life and this is what he said. Oh, how I hate to get up in the morning. Oh, how I love to remain in bed.
Definitely
for the hardest blow of all is to hear the
I buy it now. Very what's, good. What's good here, Bill.
Yeah, Bill, I'm impressed.
Did he appear in any Broadway musicals?
Musicals.
No, he never did Broadway. He did plays on Broadway, but not musical. He did The Odd Couple on Broadway with Art Carney, but he never did a musical. He did appear in Hello, Dolly! And had a very small singing part in that. But this was a TV special starring George Burns, where I got this from, and they were plugging the movie that they had just made, the Sunshine Boys.
Oh, yeah.
Remember that movie?
Absolutely.
Loved it.
Yeah. All right. Well, very good. Well, Bill, we have a WBZ pen for you.
I am very excited.
All right. You should be. Hold on for Rob. He'll get your mailing information.
Thank you, Bill. Thank